In this video, I have explained you the procedure to find the root of an equation by using Atkins delta square method. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, share this video link with your friends, gain the knowledge and rule the world. Atkins delta square method. This method is a modification over the iterative method which accelerates the convergence of a solution of the given equation. That means this particular method, when we use it, will take us nearly to the solution of a given equation. That means 99% we get the exact solution by using Atkins delta square method. The process of Atkins delta square method is described as below. Let f of x equal to 0 be the given equation. So whatever the question will be there, in that question an equation will be given. You need to consider that equation as f of x equal to 0. X naught be the initial approximation of the root. We need to find x naught as the assumption, and considering that as the initial approximation of the root, write down the equation in the form x is equal to g of x. So whatever the equation has been given, by using that equation you need to convert that into a form such that x is equal to g of x. That means on the left hand side you should have an x term, and on the right hand side you should have the terms other than the x. That means on the left you should have only one term, and that should be x, and all the remaining terms should be present on the right hand side, and that we consider as an g of x. Find the two approximations x1 and x2 by the iterative method. So x0 is the initial approximation which we get by using the equation f of x, and you need to find now two approximations x1 and x2 by using an iterative method. To find x1 and x2, we will be using a function xn plus 1 is equal to g of xn. By using xn plus 1 equal to g of xn, that means x1 we get, x1 will be equal to g of x0, and x2 will be equal to g of x1. Because when we write n is equal to 0, x0 plus 1 will be x1 and will be equal to g of x0, and when we write n is equal to 1, 1 plus 1 it will be a 2, therefore x2 will be equal to g of x2. That means whatever the equation has been given, you need to consider that equation as f of x, and you need to find the initial approximation of the root for the given equation f of x, and that you need to assume as x0, and we have to write the equation in the form x is equal to g of x, and using that one you need to find x1 and x2. To find the third approximation x3, use the formula by taking n equal to 1, and the formula is x3n equal to x3n minus 1 minus delta x3n minus 2 whole square divided by delta square x3n minus 3. So for this equation, that is the formula, you need to write n is equal to 1. When we write n is equal to 1, 3 into n will be 3. That means it will be x3, and equal to x3n minus 1. So 3n minus 1, 3 into 1 is 3, minus 1 will be equal to 2, therefore it will be x2. The next term, delta x3n minus 2. So 3 into 1 will be 3, 3 minus 2 will be 1, therefore it will be delta x1 whole square, whereas the denominator delta square x3n minus 3, 3 into 1 is 3, 3 minus 3 is 0, so it will be delta square x0. Therefore putting n is equal to 1 in this formula, we get x3 is equal to x2 minus delta x1 whole square divided by delta square x naught. X3 is equal to x2 minus delta x1 whole square divided by delta square x naught, where delta x1 will be equal to x2 minus x1. It is called as an finite first difference, and delta square x naught equal to delta x1 minus delta x naught. It is called as an second finite difference. Second finite difference, whereas the first one is called as an finite first difference, and the second one is finite second difference. These values we calculate by considering a table, which I will be explaining in the problem which we are going to solve by using Atkins method. Now, with this approximation, we get the value of x3. Then find the next two approximations, x4 and x5, using iterative formula. So iterative formula is again that g of x n plus 1 is equal to g of x, right? We have got the value of x3 by using this formula. Again, for the next approximation, we need to find two approximations, x4 and x5, using the iterative formula, xn plus 1 is equal to g of xn. That is, if you write n is equal to 3, x3 plus 1, that is x4, will be equal to g of x3, and x4 plus 1, that is x5, will be equal to g of x4. Now, using x4 and x5, we need to get the value of x6. That is, the second approximation is obtained by using the formula x3n equal to x3n minus 1 minus delta x3n minus 2 whole square divided by delta square x3n minus 3. That is, the second approximation x6 is obtained by using this formula. And here in this formula, if we put n equal to 2, we get, so x3n will be equal to 3 into 2, that is a 6, that is x6 equal to 3n minus 1. So 3 into 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5, therefore it is x5, minus delta 3n minus 2, that is 6 minus 2, it will be x4 whole square, delta x square whole square divided by delta square x3, because x3 into 2 minus 3, 3 into 2 is 6, 6 minus 3 is 3. Therefore, what we get, x6 is equal to x5 minus delta x4 whole square divided by delta square x3. Now, continue this process till we get the root to the desired place of approximation. That means, until we get the approximate root for a given equation to the desired decimal places, we can continue this process. That is, by using an iterative, we need to find the value of x1, x2, and then by using this formula, we need to find the value of x3. Then x4 and x5 can be obtained by using an iterative formula. Again, by using this formula, you need to get the value of x6. Then x7 and x8 can be obtained by using an iterative formula, and x9 can be obtained by using this formula, that is x3n equal to x3n minus 1 minus delta x3n minus 2 whole square divided by delta square x3n minus 3. The above procedure of computing successive approximation root is called Atkins delta square method. So this procedure is called as an Atkins delta square method. And the formula which we use to calculate x3, x6, x9, etc., that is the formula x3n equal to x3n minus 1 minus delta x3n minus 2 whole square divided by delta square x3n minus 3. This formula is called as an Atkins formula. So it is a procedure to calculate the root for a given equation by using Atkins delta square method. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, share this video link with your friends, gain the knowledge and rule the world.